Hi everyone, just here to showing you another improvement that we've made to the surveyor, to our 2021 surveyor 19B HLE. And this one involves a dinette. As you can see, for those that have the surveyor, these legs are a little different, right? So what we did is we bought some step two table legs and installed them on our top. And there you have it. We have a new new table legs for the table. And this is pretty cool because it folds up and down. And just to give you a quick overview of what we did, because I did another video, it was really long, it was like 12 minutes, but I'm sure this can be condensed in quite a bit less, or a shorter video rather. And all we did was just, undid the four components of the existing table legs. And we still have the posts sitting there. I feel bad for you 2022 people, because look, 2021, bam, storage space from the bottom and from the top too, I guess, if we wanted to. But what was I saying? Oh yeah, so we put these table legs on. First we did it by screwing cutting this piece of wood. I need to take measurements and post them for you guys, but we cut this piece of wood out to kind of do two things: to kind of raise the table up a little bit, because these table legs are shorter than the original dinette table legs, so the countertop sat a little low. Not much lower, it would have been comfortable for the kids, but I just decided to bump it up a little bit just because. And again, that was one reason, but the main reason for actually putting this wood was to create a space for these screws to be able to screw into. And not only that, but also create a positive stop for those screws to be able to screw into. If you just use those screw holes, I'm sorry, it keeps coming out blurry, I'm not sure why, but if you just use the existing screw holes and you don't use a piece of wood and you just screwed straight into that table, what'll happen is, if you don't have the torque setting set on your drill at like really low, it would have to be something like 3 or 2 or, you know, maybe 4. If you have it set anywhere above that, you're just gonna cross thread the wood and you're just gonna pull a lot of it with it. I mean, you're just gonna pull a lot of it out, and the screws won't actually adhere to anything. They're just going to be spinning around there. And you're just going to be mad at yourself. So what the wood does, it kind of gives the screw a positive stop. And I was able to drill, I think, in torque setting like 9. First, I pre-drilled the wood. And then I screwed it in. And that kind of gives you a stop point once the screw reaches inside this softer MDF material. And it stops it from pulling the threads out, or rather, what do you call it? Do you call that cross-threading on wood? I have no idea, but it stops you from doing that. It stops you from messing up the counter on the top. Not only that, you can also put in longer screws that, if you don't have short screws, you can put in longer screws and still be able to attach this tabletop to the table legs. I mean, it doesn't sound like it makes sense to me right now, but I think it does. If it doesn't, let me know in the comment section and I'll try to explain better. I'll do a follow-up video or something. And I also use some construction adhesive in between the tabletop and the piece of wood. And I didn't put a lot. Just so you know, if I do ever sell this trailer, I'm keeping these legs. I think we're going to end up keeping these legs because they were expensive. And if you do buy it, you're going to end up getting the old system back on there, unless you want to pay more, then that's always acceptable, I guess. But just to give you a demonstration of how it goes down, well, the tabletop goes down now, not how it's going to go down, but let's see. So I'll show you quickly how I do it. And my wife got a tripod, so now I'm not doing these crazy, or shaking the video, I guess, as much as I used to. All right, so there we are. First thing you do is you pull this latch here, that's kind of a locking latch. It removes the lock from the mechanism. And then you pull it toward you and it starts sliding down. And then as it's kind of almost a bit of a way down, just grab it and push it and sit it on your bump stops and it's down. All the way down. So now to pull it up, it's a little more tricky. It takes a little finesse. But what you need to do is you need to step on one of these just to be able to get leverage to pull it up. So as you're pulling it, you pull it towards you, but you're holding your foot down on one of those so that it starts spreading out. Probably doesn't make sense, but you'll see what I'm trying to do. I don't know if I'll be able to set the tripod down. No, I guess I'll just hold it. So I'm going to put my foot there rather than show you an ugly foot. I'll just tell you I put my foot there and I'm holding it. I'm starting to pull now. And then pulling it up. But at this point, once you get about halfway, you need to start pulling it out. Out toward you. And then keep holding it with your foot. And then push it away from you toward the wall. And then it'll lock in place. And the reason you're pulling it toward you is because if you continue to just pull it up and then push it, you're going to smack the wall. So that'll stop you from doing that. And that's about it. I mean, we still have some issue with the bump stops. You know, I had to move my bump stops in the back because they weren't really providing much support to the table. You can see where the screws were before, and I've kind of moved them up a little bit to kind of be similar to the ones that were in the front. But I think I prefer to move them even further inward to provide more support for this table, because I'm not very confident of this MDF material. It's really cheap. And the other thing we did was... am I losing one already? We put these little blisters in. And I'm not sure why that one's like that. But we put these little blisters in, obviously, to protect the wall from the table. And that was it. So if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to post them in the comment section. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it or if you found it useful. If you didn't find it useful, you know, I mean, it's America. You don't have to give me a thumbs down. You can just tell me in the comment section. That'd be great. But yeah, if you have a surveyor, I think you should do this. Not only does it liberate you from having those feet there, not only is the process of pulling it upward a bit easier, but now you have a table that you can take outside if you need it outside. So a bit of versatility there. And if you have a GeoPro, because I had a GeoPro before, B16 or G16 BHS, you should do this too. I think it's a better solution than having the table legs there. And again, it gives you the versatility of having a table you can take outside. So that's about it. If you have any questions or comments, just leave them in the comment section. Thanks a lot. Take care.